Okay, Michael Faraday performed experiments, electrochemical experiments, in which he caused metals to be deposited onto an electrode, a cathode, and to reduce a metal ion is necessary to add electrons to it. So they were using batteries at the time to do these experiments. And in honor of Michael Faraday, they named a constant after him. But we'll start by understanding where the Coulomb, which is the basic unit of charge, comes from. The Coulomb is named after, I think his name is Charles Coulomb, who did experiments in electrostatics. He invented an apparatus that was in the form of a bell jar with a horse hair as a torsion, as a sort of torsion bar, and he did experiments on electrostatic attraction using this apparatus, this primitive apparatus, and from which he was able to deduce the laws of attraction for electrostatics. So they named the basic unit of charge after him. One electron has a charge of 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19 coulombs. So if you were to take a mole of electrons, which is a standard unit of measurement when we're dealing with atoms, if you take 6.02 times 10 to the 23 electrons, and you multiply the charge on each electron with the number of electrons, you get a number, 96,485. That is the charge on one mole of electrons. And that is called the Faraday, and has units of coulombs per mole. So a mole of electrons has this charge of 96,000 coulombs, and that unit itself is called Faraday in honor of Michael Faraday, who did these electrostatic experiments. Here's an experiment that was typical of what Michael Faraday would have done. If you were to deposit 25 grams of silver onto a cathode, how much energy was used to do this? And the way we determine that is to use the change in free energy for the reaction is equal to negative NFE, where N is the number of moles of electrons deposited, F is Faraday's constant, and E is the voltage of the cell. Now, when you do deposit silver onto a cathode, there's one electron necessary to deposit one atom. So if you had a mole of silver, it would take a mole of electrons to deposit that mole of solid silver. And the electrochemical potential for that reaction is 0.7799 volts. The units of volts, by the way, are joules per coulomb. So it takes a joule of energy to move a coulomb of electrons, or a coulomb of charge, through a field of 1 volt. So if you plug in all these numbers into this equation, delta G is equal to negative NFE, we have 25 grams of silver, which is a little bit less, it's less than a quarter of a mole of silver. So it's grams of silver over grams per mole times the Faraday constant F, which is 96,485 coulombs per mole, times the voltage for that reaction, 0.799 joules per coulomb. You'll see that coulombs cancel, moles cancel, and grams cancel. The only unit that's left is joules. So that's the amount of energy that can be released by depositing that amount. So in that case, because it's negative, the free energy is available for doing work. And in this case, it takes 1.79 times 10 to the 4 joules of energy, or 1.79 times 10 to the 4 joules of energy are available to do work in this case for the if we deposit 25 grams of silver onto an electrode.